I just took a 2-hour nap. Honestly, that's a slay for this night that we have. Guys, I don't know how to tell you this. But Midnight's literally comes out in like 4 freaking hours, and I don't know how I'm saying that. Like, I'm sitting here like in bed, like I allotted time. I was like, okay, I'm gonna go get something to eat. I'm gonna come home and sleep. And then like my phone kept going off because like Taylor Nation was active again. And like it's getting pretty close to the time that we need to tune into the game. I'm sorry, I'm still waking up. Tune into the game because Taylor is going to release a teaser for something in the 3rd quarter. And I was like kind of just laying there. I was like kind of dozing in and out, like trying to catch my Z's as much as possible. But like I have this rush of serotonin through me, like this absolute like rush. So Midnight's literally comes out tonight. Oh my God. We're literally starting the release day vlog. It's gonna be wild. So I'm gonna get in the shower now, and then I'm going to Dairy Queen and getting a latte. If you don't know what a latte is, it's like coffee at Dairy Queen. And that's something I desperately need because about 11:20, I'm gonna get my little vehicle and skirt over to the record store. I'm gonna be at the record store when Midnight's comes out. I'm gonna be with my friend Callie, and here's the deal. They're doing a special Midnight's opening, and they have all the CDs. They didn't get their full vinyl truck, so I'll definitely be going back tomorrow afternoon to get my vinyl, vinyls. Let's see how many I end up with. But I definitely wanna get all the CDs, and I'm afraid if I don't go at Midnight, they're gonna sell out because I know that their shipment wasn't huge. Anyways. I'm shook. Like, they're gonna literally be open for like 15 minutes at Midnight. They're just doing this for the Taylor Swift fans, and I love them, adore them, applaud them. But tomorrow Callie and I are actually gonna hang out. Her and I are gonna go get like coffee. We're gonna go to Target and go back to the record store, and it's gonna be a blast. The epiphany I had literally while I was half asleep and texting her, because she was like, I desperately like need to find like the lavender one. I'm like, okay, like in the morning, like we'll definitely like look, see, you know, what Targets around just like have it, whatever. And she was like, I desperately need to hear like the deluxe track. And I'm like, wait, why did it just hit me that I have a CD player in my car? Like, I don't know why, it didn't click. But yeah, I'm so excited, you guys. We literally get a brand new Taylor Swift album tonight. Like, and I don't even know like what I'm wearing. Look at my hair. But I don't even know what like I'm wearing tomorrow or tonight. I do have this sweater picked out. It looks very like retro Midnight's vibes. So I'm almost thinking that with like my mom jeans that literally are glued to my body. I'm so excited. I'm gonna stop rambling. I'm gonna go ahead and shower. This is gonna be a dang long vlog. So definitely grab a snack. Oh my God. And I'm watching football for Taylor Swift. Turnover margin, and talking about every possession. Anyways, they play good. I got a mulatte, so it's okay. And they're down 6 at least for now. See what they get. You guys, so Taylor, what the heck? She announced that she's doing Midnight's movies, which I'm guessing this is kind of like going to be like a visual album. I'm assuming that maybe she did one for each song because she said she wanted to represent this album visually. Oh my God, you guys, you look so good. It reminded me of like Look What You Made Me Do with all the Taylors. I'm obsessed. Hello. So I'm back under the covers because I tried to film a clip and I was freezing and just shivering because I was under the covers and I'm wearing shorts, which I don't think was my brightest move. But anyways, so now I'm just here, but I'm about to get up and relax. Funny. I am sleep deprived, but I'm about to go ahead and get ready, touch up my makeup. I'm not doing a full face by any means. I'm just gonna like touch up like my little, yeah, that. So I can take a couple pictures when I go to the record store. I'm about to get Midnight's. Like, I'm literally about to get it. Like, that's crazy. I'm meeting up with my friend Callie there,
And we're going to take some pictures, and then I'm pretty much just going to, because they open it literally at 12 o'clock, and they're going to be open for, like, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, and then they're closing. Like, they're just selling midnights, like, just briefly, and they're getting their other shipment in the morning, but I'm so excited, and I'm scared it's going to sell out, so that's why I'm going, and then, like, I'm going to listen to the album. I'm so excited, you guys. It's just beginning to.
You guys, I'm dressed and ready to go to the record store. I actually wore this because I feel like it's kind of like the Taylor Swift retro vibe. I wanted to wear Taylor merch because I'm going to wear like a Midnight's themed outfit for actual release day, but I just have on like my mom jeans and this little pullover, and I think it's cute. I just pulled on my little floral shoes. They really don't match, but they're comfortable to drive in, and I feel like comfort is key, and literally I'm leaving now.
That's awesome.
You're welcome to come in and listen. You got her to do it. I'm shaking. I know we should, but your eyes are flying saucers from other fucking
situations, circumstances, miscommunication. Okay, alright, alright. Right, okay, oh freaking K. Okay, they invited us in a couple minutes early. By a couple minutes early, I literally mean like 5 minutes early. And I have all of them. Oh my God. And then I also got the Moonstone one for now of the vinyl. I can't even speak, but I can tell you that I'm a question stan. I'm so happy right now. I'm literally gonna listen to it on the way home. This is so good. I don't even know what to say. Hi, I'm home now. I pulled up to McDonald's and got a sweet tea, a coffee, and a Happy Meal because it's gonna be a long night. And I am obsessed. I question, listen. I think it's my number one right now, but I'm not sure because I'm obsessed with them all. You guys, like, I really wish I had any thoughts, but like, I cannot choose a favorite. I'm just merely trying to, but like, bop after bop. When I tell you guys, I can't stop listening to this album. I cannot stop listening to this album. It is literally 2:37 in the morning, and I, you know, when I started this journey, I was feeling very, very tired, but that tiredness has literally gone out the window. And it's the way Taylor's, like, very chaotic surprise is literally, like, in about 20 minutes, 22 minutes to be exact, and I'm, like, fully awake. Around 11 o'clock, I was like, oh my God, how am I gonna make it? But, like, Honestly, it might have been the McDonald's stop, but I am so wide awake. Labyrinth is actually the one on the album that makes me, like, the most emotional. That and Sweet Nothing. I'm a Labyrinth stan. Like, I called that one. I love Labyrinth so much, like, right off the gate. I love them all, though. Like, it's so hard to choose. Oh my God, I'm obsessed, you guys. This is crazy. I'm buzzing. Like, this is so good. I love Taylor so much. I love her so much. She just always goes out of her way to, like, make releases fun and, like, so on theme and, you know, going to the record store at, like, midnight and, like, seeing people who, you know, love Taylor, too, just made me so happy. Like, they started to play the album, like, right when we walked in. I think I said that when I got in the car. But I don't know. It was just such a connection, and it just made me so happy. And then, like, I got in my car, and I honestly was, like, planning to, like, come home, come straight home, and, like, listen to the album, but, like, I was actually able to listen to the entire album, like, on my way home because I decided that I was gonna go stop by McDonald's, too.
And it was just like, I couldn't stop listening to it in the car. Like, listening to it by myself in my car, like, my jaw was like, it's so good. Oh my God. I cannot wait to go to, like, Target tomorrow and, like, get the lavender edition and take more pictures. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Guys, I just want to celebrate this album forever. Like, it's so, so good. Reporting live at 2:59, and I decided to go ahead and start videoing because a very chaotic surprise is coming. I just started crying. And I knew this was gonna happen. Like, it happens every Taylor Swift release, but it just hit me because I heard Hits different, and there's a line that says it hits different because it's you, and that's truly how I feel about Taylor. Like, yeah, I go to so many different concerts and, like, all that, but, like, truly it always is Taylor. Like, it hits different because it's her, and it's always been her, and she's my safe space, and she, oh my God, it's 3 a.m., but, and then I listened to Sweet Nothing, and it just made me start crying. So here we go. It's just reached the point where I'm like, I just cannot believe this. I love Taylor so, so much. And every moment is so special with her. What? I don't know what's happening. I have no idea what's happening right now. Taylor, hello? Seven more songs? Okay, look. Where is it? Everybody's texting me. Okay, what are they called? Okay, bonus tracks. The Great War, Bigger Than the Whole Sky, Paris, Glitch, High Infidelity, Would've, Could've, Should've, Dear Reader. Oh my God! Literally, hello Apple Music. This is insane. I know I look calm right now, but I'm literally frozen. Surprise, I think of Midnights as a complete concept album with 13 songs forming a full picture of intensities that were mystifying Mad Hour. However, there were other songs we wrote on our journey to find that magic 13. What the f- Taylor? Like we do with the vault tracks. What the f- Taylor Swift, can you take your own advice and come? All right, well, here we go. My knuckles were bruised like violin.
I'll be back.
Okay, hi. I just finished listening to the 7 new songs that are on the 3 AM edition. Listen, Paris is literally my favorite on the 3 AM edition. I love that song so much, and Glitch. Man! I'm obsessed. I'm obsessed. I really need to take off my makeup. Like, I really do. I cannot sleep in my makeup. Sleep. What's that, you ask? I'm just blowing up my phone. We're gonna FaceTime. Good morning, Swifties. It's 7:55 and the music video is about to drop. I've been awake, but I've been like dozing for like good 10 minutes. Just like on and off, but I'm actually grabbing my laptop now because we get the music video so soon. This is fashion. Swiftie fashion. Yeah, guys, like this new hairdo. It's called Taylor Swift Doesn't Let Me Sleep. It's 10 o'clock. I've just pulled myself up. I am not looking too hot, but we're definitely going to go ahead and fix this, listen to the album, and I am so excited. I've been looking to see what Targets around me have them, and it's been updated, so hopefully it keeps updating. I need coffee, I need a lavender vinyl, and I need a bop session, so let's go revise this. Why the heck? How is my wing still, like, intact but, like, tacky? What? Okay, rare beauty. Check. So I have this retro kind of looking Midnight's vibe. I thought it looked like a Midnight's vibe. Sweater on. The Old Navy mom jeans that I haven't taken off since Black Friday of last year. And my white boots. And my favorite part of my outfit is my little moon cat necklace. I actually got this at a local... Why is it so zoomed in? I got it at a local farmer's market, and I love it, and it feels very, like, Midnight's-esque. Oh, my God. Oh, and, of course, my 13 ring from Rez and Rena, and my little ring that I stack on it from New York City. I am so excited. I'm gonna go Wow, Rachel, slow down. You're really excited, but slow down. I'm going to go grab Callie, and we're gonna go to Target and get coffee and all the adventure. We're walking into Target. Oh my goodness. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. The bag has been secured. Do you wanna be in it?
Sure.
Okay, cool. I didn't know if you were comfortable being on camera. Okay, so we just walked in our local record store. And we walked up, and we love the people here. Like, they're always so, so sweet to us. And is he the manager?
Yes.
I'm guessing?
Owner manager?
Yeah, owner manager walked up, and he's like, last night was really fun, wasn't it? I was like, yeah, it was. He's like, well, we got a, like, personal thank you. I'm like, what? And he was like, yeah, Taylor's manager actually, her record label manager actually commented on the post. I was like... And we have no idea also what's happening on record store day. I need sleep. Good Lord. Sunday. No idea. They don't know either. And it's not like they're not telling us knowing, like they have no idea.
We both stare out the window.
I bought my first cassette because why not? It is so hot in here. Easy breezy, beautiful cover girl.
Oh, fuck, it's so cute.
Scared me. I've been scared of Taylor Swift for the last 24 hours. It's all right. So far I have the mahogany vinyl, the moonstone vinyl, I'm gonna get copyrighted, the lavender vinyl, and then all the CD variants. Oh, dear God, saying that out loud just makes me think that, you know, I'm crazy. Oh my God, she's insane.
This is chaos.
It is. It is. Tell the people your favorite song so far.
Vigilante Shit. For sure.
Really, for sure?
For sure.
I can't pick my favorite. Like, that's how good it is. Okay, I'm very hooked on Labyrinth, and I'm very hooked on Question and Paris. They are very good. So, yeah, we're just kind of hanging out.
It's different as good.
It is.
It's so good.
Oh, my God. Karma. Why don't people like Karma? Why? It's so good.
I don't know.
Karma is my boyfriend.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, God.
Okay. But, yeah, we have no idea what's going on. But we're just vibing. Hello, everyone. I'm at a second Target. I'm with my mother. And we're going to... Yes, sorry. Queen. And we're gonna see if they have the standout at this one. This is a different Target. It's me! Hi! And I'm back to talk about Midnights. It's Saturday now, day after album release. And this vlog is very sporadic. It's actually not probably as long as I thought it would be. And that's because I was so in the moment with this album. I actually started to hear this album in my local record store when they did the Midnight release, and I did film a couple clips, and I will insert them in this video, like, in order. But I don't know, you guys, like, I was so in the moment with this album release that I don't know, like, I know I still documented it, but even like yesterday, like, when I was with Callie, like, we were just going through like our favorites, and we were just so excited, and just, yeah, like, and I've just been dancing around with this album. Like, last night I sat around with my dad and listened to it, and then my mom and I went on a long drive today and just absolutely, like, blasted it, like, twice. And I had so much fun doing that. And every single time I listen to this album, I fall more in love with it. Labyrinth is so one of my favorites. Like, there's not one song on this album that I don't like. However, Labyrinth is just, like, elite to me. Like, it's immediately, like, one of my favorite Taylor Swift songs. Also, my finger has been very swollen. Like, look at it compared to my... Oh, my God. And I have no idea why. And it's been actually hard for me, like, even, like pick up my phone and stuff with this finger because it's just so swollen, and I don't know what I did with it. I don't know if I like slept on it weird, but it's very sore and I have no idea what I did. So that's fun. But yeah, so Labyrinth is a favorite. Anti-Hero is so much fun to sing. Like, it's me, hi, like, so much fun. Oh my God. Lavender Haze, absolutely chef's kiss. My mom and I were vibing to Lavender Haze earlier, and there's just so many that, like, just stand out so much, and there's so many where my predictions were totally wrong. But yeah, I absolutely love, like, Bejeweled. Like, I can't pick a favorite. I say, like, Labyrinth is just, like, oh my God, like, it's so good, but, like, I can't pick a favorite, if that makes sense. Question was the first one that, like, dropped my jaw fully when I first listened to it. And actually, my first song that I heard was Maroon. And when I went into the record store, they were like, hey, we can't sell you the album until literally, like, 12 o'clock. But we're actually playing it here on vinyl, so if you want to come in and, like, listen with us. So by the time we got in, they had already gone through Lavender Haze and they were on Maroon. And I remember my jaw just, like, hit the floor. Like, Maroon, I am definitely, like, vibing with. Like I said, every single song on this album is, like, so freaking good. And it's so... A lot of people are like, well, this sounds like, you know, just, like, her normal pop. But, like, it does, but, like... new, if that makes any sense. Like, Jack Antonoff, his production, oh my God, oh my God. Like, Midnight Rain, are you freaking kidding me, guys? And then we got 3 AM edition, and I was just so shocked. And by that time, at 3 AM, like, I was so in shock. But then, like, I'm so glad, like, I went back and, like, really dove into those songs and, like, listened to them. that was bound to happen, but you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just always so, on that initial listen, there's so much going through your head that it takes time to, like, process the whole thing because there's so much coming at you. And it's so overwhelming, but, like, in the best way possible. You're like, oh my god, I can't pick a favorite. I can't pick a favorite. Like, I still can't pick a favorite. Like, I'm not even kidding you. Like, I can't sit still. I can't just sit there. Like, I have to be listening to this album. I have to be listening to this album. Like, it's so good, you guys. Taylor's vulnerability is truly so inspiring, and it's so beautiful, and I'm so grateful for her. And I think that her vulnerability is absolutely empowering, and I think that it resonates a lot with people, and I'm so proud of Taylor. I will always root for her, and she's been in my life since I heard Love Story, and to literally hear how much she's evolved in her music and her lyrics and her stories is truly so beautiful. And I just want to say, I think Sweet Nothing is absolutely one of the most important songs in the album. And I say that because we hear Taylor talk about, like, her late night anxieties and, you know, what keeps her up at night and her midnights past. And then there's Sweet Nothing that she wrote with her boyfriend, Joe Alwyn, who goes by William Bowery when he writes with her. But I think that their love is so beautiful. And I think putting Sweet Nothing on that album was absolutely stunning. The way that she feels so at home with that man makes me so happy. Like, she's like, to you, I can admit that I'm just too soft for all of this. Like, she's able to vent to him. She's able to show her true self with him. It's not a candy-coated, you know, version of what she's feeling. She just knows that no matter, like, if the spotlight's too bright or if the flashing lights are too much, she can always go home to him and be like, hey, like, you know, I have some stuff to say and I really want to talk to you about it. And, like, he is there to listen and support her. And somebody said, I don't remember who said it, I did see a TikTok on it though, but somebody said that, like, Sweet Nothing is Joe's perspective of peace. Like, she's like, would it ever be enough if I can never give you peace in my life? And he's like, I'm not asking you for that, like, I'm just asking to love you. And I think it's so beautiful. And man, did I just lose it when I heard that song. Really on the second listen, when I heard that song, when we were waiting for, like, 3 a.m., I think I vlogged it even. When we were waiting for the 3 a.m. surprise, I really just, like, lost it to that song. Like, it's so beautiful. I'm so happy for Taylor, and I'm so lucky to have her as a voice of reason, as a reason to dance, as a reason to blast it in my car and feel understood. And, you know, I think that this message with the album is so important and crucial to society, that it's okay to have your anxieties. It's okay to recognize mental health struggles. I think that the stigmatism against mental health has really, I think that we need to normalize that everybody is experiencing something. Everybody has a different path, and everybody has struggles in their life. And if you walk a minute in somebody else's shoes, maybe you'd understand that. And I think maybe because Taylor is in the spotlight, and maybe because she has fame and money and a beautiful face, that people think her life is perfect, but she doesn't feel that way. And I just think it's so crucial for people to hear the underlying messages of this album and understand how she feels behind the camera and how she wants to feel appreciated, and how, you know, no matter how many times somebody's like, oh my god, Taylor, you're doing a great job, she's still, like, doubting herself. And that's heartbreaking, but I think that that's something we all go through. And I think that this album's so universal in the message. And I love Midnight so much. It's such a bop. She did so well with this album. And guys, it's so good. Like, I'm in love with it. I can't stop listening to it. I will say, on my drive today with my mom, Dear Reader really hit for both of us. Like, the lyrics were just like, oh my god. Like, Taylor Swift is literally giving us life lessons right now. And it's so good. I can't get past any of it. Like, I could sit here and say, like vigilante shit. Like, we should all be terrified of Taylor Swift. Like, don't cross Taylor Swift. But yeah, I'm very proud of her, and I love her so much, and I'm so glad that I got to share this with you guys. I'm sorry if this vlog was kind of, like, brief and sporadic, but I feel like my release day vlogs always feel that way, but then they end up, like, making sense when I watch them back. But yeah, I was just living in the moment and, still trying to share that with you guys, but Taylor Swift releases are so important to me. She's been in my life for so long. And so I definitely wanted to document it for you guys. And I actually got one of my merch pieces today. And I'm so excited because I'm going to do an unboxing for you guys as usual. And look at my necklace. I got this at a local like craft event. But I'm in love with it. And I will be wearing it every day because it gives me midnights. And I love you guys so much. Thank you guys so much. The midnights content is not stopping here. We know that because I can't stop talking about Taylor Swift. I can't shut up about Taylor Swift. It's me. Hi. I can't stop talking about Taylor Swift. So you guys look forward to some content, hopefully some unboxings. And I love you guys so much. And definitely let me know what you think of this album below. Part of me really just wants to do like a full video on maybe like every single song, like what I think. And, or like my first reaction to it and stuff, but I don't know. I'm so scatterbrained right now because there's so much going on, but yeah. I love you guys. I hope this video entertained you in some way. Definitely let me know below what your favorite song is right now. And I love you guys, and I hope to see you, yes, you, in the next one. Bye, guys.